Hi there, my name is Dan, and I'm a peer advisor at GCC. Today I'm going to show you how to sign up for classes. The first thing you want to do is go to GCC's website, gccmass.edu, and on the homepage, on the top there's a My GCC button. You want to select that. Select the Secure Login button, which is right here, and then you're brought to this page. And when you're here, you need your ID, so you want to put your ID number in. And then your PIN number, which is actually your date of birth, but only 6 digits of it. So 2 for the month, 2 for the date, and 2 for the year. And you want to press login. And once you're here, there's personal information, student, final grades. That's not important right now. So we want to go to student, registration information. And you come to your registration page. You want to select term, fall 2011, submit. And then you want to select register, add or drop classes, click. And then you need to put your registration PIN in, which you need to obtain from your personal advisor. And submit. Okay, let's sign up for classes. So down here, you can go to class search, and it comes up to the lookup for classes page. You can search subject, course number. It's very helpful. Now, I need to take an English, so I'm going to go to English, class search. Down here it shows what is open. This is a 200. I haven't even taken 112 or 114 or 116 yet, so I'm going to take this 112 right here. So I want to select it and then go to this register button right below, and clicking register is going to register me for the class. Next class. I'm planning on taking 12 credits, so class search. Now I want to take philosophy. So I go down to philosophy, I go to class search button, press that, and then I select the philosophy class I want to take, register, the button below, and this will take me back to my previous page with all the classes I signed up, and it shows that I am in the, Philosophy 103, web registered, and I have 8 credits so far. I need another class, so I'm going to go back to class search down here, select that. And I want to take an art class. I'm not sure which one, but I want to take an art class. Okay, so I'm going to take this color. I'm going to press the select, and then I'm going to press register, and I'm registering for the class. So I'm back at the add drop classes, and Art 141, the color which I just signed up for, shows I am web registered. It shows that I am signed up for 11 credits for the 4 classes. I'd like to take a history class. Right there, I'm going to select history and class search again. Now I want to take 105, so I'm going to click it and register down here. Okay, this sometimes happens. From the previous page for signing up for the history class, I didn't select it right. So we're going to go back, and you can see I don't have the class signed up. So I'm going to go back to class search, history. I'm going to press class search. And I want to make sure that the green arrow's in there. That means I've selected it. And I want to press the register button. And yep. That is the 5th class, the Women in American History class. It's a good class. And 14 credits total. At this point, I am done signing up for classes for the semester. I'm signed up for my classes for the fall. I'm all set. I have my 14 credits, my 5 classes. Now I want to print out a detailed schedule of it with the times and the places. And so I want to go up here. I want to press student, which is highlighted in blue. Then I want to press registration information, which is the first one. Click it. I want to go down to the 4th and student detailed schedule. Press that. And if you scroll down, you can see that my classes, all the information pertaining to the classes, where, when, and who I'm taking them with. And what you want to do is just go to file print. Print it, and that'll be really helpful when it comes to the first day with all the students running around trying to find where their classes are. And the last thing to do is, over on the right, there's the exit button. That just logs me out, and I am done for the day for signing up for classes. I want to sign up for an English class, so 112 is the class I want to take right there. You just want to select it by selecting the class, and then by registering it will register it. So I'm not registered for the class. This class, there's an add error. Now in this issue, the waitlist issue, which the class is already filled up, but you know, people do drop in the first few weeks, so you're able to waitlist it. Right now it is closed, but there are 4 people on the waitlist. So if I press the action and I go down, it says waitlist and registration pending, I can click that. 4 people have already signed up on the waitlist, so I will be the 5th. And if I click the submit changes, I am technically signed up on the waiting list, which means I'm not technically in the class. I want to take a theater class. So I do class search down here again, press that. Now this does happen every once in a while. The C in the select stands for closed, and in this situation, the class is closed completely. It's filled with 10 students, the waitlist is filled, and so there's nothing I can do. I can't sign up for this class. I can make an appointment with my advisor, and they can keep me up to date if the class does open. Also, if you do check back before the semester starts, classes do reopen, so you can always try to get in, but at this point the class is closed, so I'm going to go back to class search. So let's search the next class you want to take, or I'm going to take. Personal communication skills, I selected that, and class search, and we're going to select this class, which is the intercultural communication. I heard it's a great class. Register. And this should take me back to my registration page. And okay, there's another error. This is a time conflict with which class? CRN, which is the number 1002. So we look up here, CRN's 1002. So it's conflict with my English class, which I want to take. But the issue is I'm on the waiting list. So I think what I'm going to do is drop this. So I'm going to go to Action, Web Drop. I'm going to submit the changes. Now I have to go back to class search, knowing that I dropped the English, and re-register for the personal communication skills, because I wasn't registered. It just showed me that there was a conflict. And with the English gone, now I'm in this class, I'm web registered, and I can start this class in the fall. The next class I like to sign up for, so I'm going to go to class search. Where are you? Oh, French. Okay. Took some French in high school. So we're going to do class search. And the French film and language sounds interesting. That's one I'd like to take. So I'm going to register for that by pressing the register button down here. And okay, it didn't show up here. Another registration add error. So this class, because it's a 200 level class, 257, it requires a prerequisite, which is the 100 level French classes, which I actually haven't even taken here. If this occurs, this prerequisite or test score, you can test into certain languages. But if this does happen, let's say you already taken the class and for some reason it's not registering it, you need to go to your advisor and they can do it for you, override the system. For these, you can't override this. So for right now, you can write down that you want to meet with your advisor to try to get into this class. And so for right now, I'm going to go back to class search and find another class. If life does interfere with schoolwork, which you know it does a lot of the time in work, you can go back, you can do the secure login, and we can re-log back in. I'll show you, you need your ID number. And then your PIN number, which is your 6-digit birth date. And log back in. Now, if you do this later on, classes do change availability and classes close really quickly, so I would say get this done as soon as possible. You just want to go back to student, which is the second one, select that. Registration information, and then the register, add or drop classes again. Submit. Now I get back to the classes I'm signed up for, all 5. Now I can't take Women in American History anymore. I took a few extra hours at work. It conflicts with that, so I need to drop it. So I'm going to go back down. I'm going to go to the last one, make sure it's the, yep, History 131, Women in American History. On the action, I want to select Web Drop. Press that. And then Submit Changes, which is down below. Click that. And yes, I have dropped that class. I am now at 11 credits in the 4 classes.